this week's tutorial is a sweet little Valentine's Day sign. Now, I do not normally get super into Valentine's Day, but my toddler is in a stage where she loves all things pink and sparkly and hearts and love, and so let's embrace it this year. Why don't we? So I am doing, instead of just a Valentine's sign, it's going to say Love Day, and I am using two colors of acrylic that I got in my last Cerulean Tide subscription box. So I'm using their 5x7 pieces, so I'm going to make a small sign. If you're using full sheets, go crazy if you want. And I'm using 1/8 inch sorbet pastel acrylic, and I'm using 1/8 inch frosted berry, just if you're curious. So I'm going to start with the type tool. I didn't mean to click and hold so that whole menu popped out. Just click the type tool and go ahead and just click anywhere. I'm going to type in love. Okay, fair enough. Use my selection tool to just make this larger. And actually, I might just come on up here to the font size and just hit 200. Okay, I'm also going to change to Wild Mango font. It's a boho style font that I really enjoy, and it's got some fun glyphs. So let me show you how to access those. Go back to your type tool, click inside your text box just so that it pops up when you use it. Come up to type and glyphs. And if your font, the font that you're using, has glyphs and there's alternative characters that the font designer put in there for you, then they'll show up here. So I don't want to go too wild with the glyphs, but I do want to use a couple here. So I'm using that L, and I am going to come find a cuter V. Okay. And so already you can see how using glyphs can really shift the character of any signs that you're making. Okay, so that's love, and now I want to click out of here and do a separate text box for day, and I'm using a separate text box just so that I can manipulate them separately, and we'll combine them later on. So do the same thing with the font and glyphs, and I'm going to just use a fancier D. I wish this one had a fancier Y with like a deep thing down here, but it doesn't, so that's okay. All right, so I'm now happy with this. I'm going to just place it where it looks nice. I'm trying to keep in mind my final design, which is going to have two layers. So I want to leave room for stuff to go around too. Okay, so play around with your own, whatever font you're using. You don't have to use Wild Mango. And when you're happy with it, go ahead and select and then right-click Create Outlines. If you're using a script font, come on over and do that Pathfinder click to unite so that any overlapping parts don't cut separately. And then do the same thing here. And again, we'll just do that Pathfinder Unite, and then just go ahead and make sure that your words are exactly where you want them in relation to one another. And I liked how it was. Once it is, I'm going to go ahead and select both of those, Pathfinder Unite, and that way it's all being treated as, it's all being treated as one shape. Okay, so let's redo that because I had to undo. Okay, so now you can click and move it all around. Okay. So you've got options here, of course, but the first step, no matter what, pretty much what you're doing, is going to be to come to Object, Path, Offset Path, and I'm going to do a pretty big offset because I want it to overlap. I want it to make a full, complete backing here. And I might even go, I want you to pay attention to the edges here because we're actually going to, I know it looks all wild right now, but it's going to be nice and neat at the end, but you want to look at, you know, where your letters are meeting. And I actually want this part to be a little bigger, so let's try a 0.6. And I'm okay with that. I think I did like the 0.5 better. So mess around with it, see what you like the best, and then go ahead and hit OK. Before you click off or anything, while this part with all its little interlocking pieces is selected, you'll notice that the letters part is not selected, or it's would also be highlighted blue. Go ahead and Pathfinder Unite. Come over here, switch your fill and stroke, and now what we have is two layers. Now, you can, if you're making your sign out of wood or something that engraves really nicely, you can just stop here. This would be an engraved letters on a cutout backing. Okay, and again, that's a wonderful choice. It's not what I'm doing, so stick with me if you wanna make a two-layer sign like the sample. So you'll see that when I click now, they're all connected. Okay, so it selects it all. It selects the letters and the offset path. I should be more specific. So come on up to Object Ungroup. Okay, and we actually don't want all these letters to be individual. We do want to connect those back. We just wanted the letters to be separate from the offset. So click one of the letters, come up to select same fill color, and it'll select everything that is filled in black. And then you can just Pathfinder unite those again, or you can object group them or what have you. Okay, so now I want to copy my letters and bring them over here. This is going to be my cutout top layer. All right, and mine, it's going to be that pastel acrylic. However, you see that part of the letters are super, super thin. And remember that a laser cuts not by just kind of sliding in between the molecules and forcing them apart, but actually burning away some of it. And so I'm just really nervous that this will burn to a crisp if I cut it just as is. And I really hate having to worry about that. So I'm going to actually do an object path offset path here as well. Obviously not as large, and just do a 0.02. And what that does is it just gives it a little extra thickness. And once you've done that, just make sure you're selecting both the letters and the offset. Let's zoom in so you can see that. All right. So you want to make sure that everything is selected and come to Pathfinder Unite. Okay. And then you can even switch it over, swap that fill and stroke, and just make sure everything just combined the way that you wanted it to. Now, you can even go a little thicker than this. You could do a 0.04 offset, 0.03. It just depends on what you want your final piece to look like. I'm comfortable with this, so I'm going to leave it right there. Now, over here, I don't want this to engrave. There's no point since I'm going to glue letters on top. But what I do want is scored placement lines so that I don't have to eyeball where everything goes. I'm terrible at that. Most people are terrible at that. So we're going to use that same object path offset path tool. So object path offset path. And this time we're going to do a negative offset. So negative means that it will go toward the inside of the letter rather than the outside. So negative 0.04 is usually where I start. And I just want to make sure everything is showing up for me. Now, I don't need this little skinny part. And in fact, it makes me a little more relieved that that little skinny part is not there because I don't need to worry that it might accidentally somehow show. All right. But I do want this little V placement because especially with a skinny little part right here, when you go to actually glue that on, this part can be kind of flexible and you would just want to make sure that you're putting this part and this part where it needs to be. So it's nice that this little top bit and this part are showing. I know I keep saying this part, instead of using appropriate technical terms. I hope you'll bear with me for that. And then whenever you are comfortable with the level of offset, go ahead and just hit OK. And then don't click off of anything, just come on over and change it to whatever color you use for your score lines. I use this green color for whatever reason. And then just swap the fill and stroke so that it isn't an engrave, instead it's a stroke, and then copy. So on my Mac, it's Command C. If you're using a PC, it'll be Control C, or you can just do Edit Copy, delete it. Okay, then select the original letters, delete those two. Now you have this blank cutout, which is a little alarming, but you'll go Edit, Paste in Place. It's important that you do Paste in Place and not just Paste. Paste will put it wherever. Paste in Place puts it exactly where it was, which is what you want, okay? So I plan to back my sorbet acrylic in 3M adhesive so that I can just peel and stick it together when it all gets cut out, but you can glue it if you want to. That's fine. Okay, so this is just, again, it's a simple layered sign. It will turn out really cute, and I would love to see what you make with this tutorial. Just tag me on Instagram at thefabletree. And if you liked this tutorial, this is actually really similar to a technique that I show in the first module of FileMakers Academy. Okay, it's one of my very first, it's actually the second project that you'll make. The first one is even more simple, if you can believe it. And we really do, in FileMakers Academy, I really do start you at the very beginning. I help you get your workspace all set up, and then I walk you through a very simple project, and then this project, and then we build on the skills that you learn in each lesson to learn more and more and more until you are making a really advanced graduation project at the very end. Okay, so I'll put a link to enroll in FileMakers Academy in the description here. If you have any comments, any questions, let me know in the comments and I will reply to you, or you can email me, Jacqueline@thefabletree.com. All right, I will see you next week.